Hey guys, Mandagon Mike Nikolaus here. Hope you're having a good day or night as it may be. In today's Looney Tune World of Mayhem video, we will be looking at the new tune Suit Suit Daffy. So, without further ado,
let's get started.
So, as usual, Scopefly have provided a stat sheet and some battles. So, let's have a look at the stats and skills first.
Did you have googled the term suit suit?
No.
Sounds like a special term for something. Haven't heard that before. Okay.
Maybe.
I will do it later. I'll let you.
Okay, so Suit Suit is a epic support tune artist from City, and that Swinging Jazz Club is probably a new building.
Yeah, for sure.
It's first time in a long time. So relationship with artists, friendship with artists, so the usual 10% attack, defense and speed when there's artist tunes around. Max power level 15,000, attack 681, defense 667, health 1683, and speed 139.
Yes, average.
Yeah. Then we have a design story. You wanna go?
Yes. Samurai in a jazz club, too fancy to have booked this performer. Duffy is making the most annoying sounds you've ever heard. He's literally screaming gibberish. Scat as shrill as it's skilled, and while someone somewhere probably bopped their head, your enemies are silenced in disgust. Keep the dodge dance going with this new artist. Support unleashing brutal crowd control and burying your enemies with stat downs. Oh,
so skills. Oop doop deedle basic attack 100% damage and then dodge chance up for 2 turns.
Okay.
That's okay.
Kukaracha special attack with a warm up of 3. Okay. Deal 15% max health damage and silence all enemies. Sorry. Stunning those already silenced and removing 100% turn meter from those already stunned. That's nasty.
For sure.
Sorry. Ooh.
Okay, Pui special attack. Cooldown warm up of 1. Remove 3 random buffs from target enemy, granting your team dodge chance up. And healing the ally with the lowest health for 80% heal power. Is it really gonna work in a dodge team?
Yeah, that makes the dodge team, I think, really, really annoying.
They already are.
Yeah. There are ways to work around it, but will be much harder with that too, I think. Yeah. Shoopity boop! Passive skill. Whenever a team member dodges, flip all buffs on the attacking enemy. That can be good or can be bad.
Yeah, but if it's all buffs, it's also the ones that are negative, no?
Yeah, yeah. That's the way I would understand that.
Still.
makes for some funny battles, I guess.
Yeah, there can be some very random unlock or lock there.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, nothing finer, also passive skill. At the end of this tune's turn, for each stat down on it, it flicked all enemies 2 of that stat down for 3 turns. Wow.
Whoa, yeah.
So if you have 5 attack down, then all enemies get 10 attack down for 3 turns.
Yes.
That's kind of a battle winner, or
yeah, that could be. I mean, I I'm just sort of thinking about the stuff, what happens in the relationship to other tunes that are so buff related. So maybe, I mean, Egghead or the Pharaoh, or then Leopold stealing that stuff. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Crazy chain reactions or unexpected outcomes.
Yep.
Humbling presence, archetype passive. At the start of the match, give all enemies a random step down for 3 turns. That's nice to have. But no game breaker, I guess.
No. Humbling strikes, another archetype passive. Whenever you attack, apply a random stat down on the target enemy for 3 turns, so more stat down. It's nice, but not really game-breaking or match-deciding.
But in the addition, it's for 3 turns? That could be add up. Could be annoying.
For sure. Yeah, I think this tune definitely have some uses. It will be make for interesting battles.
Yeah. For sure, the tune has some shrieking colors on it.
Yeah, maybe that is true. Okay, let's see. So we have some team suggestions here. Free jazz. Move your feet with these dodgy artists. Yeah, so that's a Dutch team. Penelope Couture, Suzu, Daffy, Jester, Bob,
yes.
The Flamingo Prissy. That one is obvious.
Yes, so, and I think you replace Couture with Matador.
Yeah, Matador Box.
Maybe even better choice. That's a potential 9 silence. So when Prissy goes first, then she silences all, and then comes the Suzu Daffy, and they're all stunned.
That's a really nasty.
That could be a really nasty combo. I think that's the obvious one. Silence is golden. Matata Box, Reindeer, Rodan, Suchu, Dubby, Wily, Coyote. Okay, yeah. Makes sense also. I mean, Wily. Could be replaced by any stunner in that concept, I guess.
Yeah, I don't see Wily Coyote would be my first choice.
Yeah, I think maybe Valk can silence efficiently. Some others do.
Yeah, so Valk does a 4 turn silence. What happens when that gets swapped to stun? Is it 4 turn stun or 1 turn stun?
Interesting question. I think it goes away when you get a new turn, so you miss 1 turn. Otherwise, it would be too heavy. I mean, Valkyrie's silence comes with a turn meter reduce also, so that would be really really nasty.
Yeah. Well, okay. Let's try to see how these teams work. I guess we have some battles of each.
So, this Duffy has a pretty expensive dentist, it seems. So, does he really belong into a jazz club with this?
Doesn't really look like, no, more like some kind of fancy disco thing.
Yeah, I think so. The wrong musician in the wrong club, like the Blues Brothers. When they enter the country pub, or what it's called, and they say, we can do both country and western. Let's start with.
The animation doesn't look too special, I guess.
No.
Beep beep.
With his blonde hair and his shiny teeth. Oh dear.
Saw on the ice. So we actually did give them doubles that down or what? It looks like that on Kusama anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, from what I see, I would say from paper, I'd say the other combo is more efficient. But we'll see.
Yeah, I agree with you. The other combo looks better. Let's go to the second battle. Yeah, that's the other team.
Yeah, I think that's cool. Though I think maybe Couture is, if replaced with Mataba, maybe even has more sting. But maybe it costs the synergy half. I think the Flamenca Prissy is an Arcus 2 use.
I don't actually remember.
I think so. Yeah. I think this performance of that team combo is more convincing.
Yeah, I also think so. The other team is, I don't know, I would change Vile with something else. Okay, next battle, that's still the,
yeah,
the Flamingo Jester team. Those teams are already hard to beat. I think now it's gonna be a little bit worse.
Yeah. I think the best approach is direct brute force attack. So, if a face is facing an arena, I'll normally go with something not too fancy but straightforward. So. And normally you try to neutralize the Flamenco first. And then the Jester. But now, with the two of those multiple silencer, will be hard to deal with. So the era of dodge team seems not over yet.
Definitely not. One more battle here. That's the other team.
Yep.
Meep meep. Meep.
So the opposition is a bit odd.
Yeah.
Two summit commons. And two rares, one from Progress, one from Avalonian, with no synergy.
Maybe Haruki should have made the two teams fight each other, the two suggested teams.
That would be interesting stuff. Yeah, that is a kind of mirror match. But maybe that gives already too much away. They want us to try the arena. Yeah, this train coming from out of the wall, a wall from nowhere, is a classic Looney Tunes.
Yeah, just paint a tunnel on the wall, then it's train comes.
I think I mentioned it once. There's a movie with Kirk Douglas when they employ that joke. It's obviously a parody of on Western. And it's one of the earliest roles of Arnold Schwarzenegger also.
I don't remember having seen it.
You can look it up. I have the name. Cactus Jack, I think it's called. The film is.
Okay.
And it's really somewhat ridiculous. And this painted tunnel entrance is there in it also. And a really, really, really young Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah, well, he have to have started somewhere.
That's true. I mean, the early Schwarzenegger films are really trash gems, yeah.
Okay, that was the last battle, so I guess that is it.
Okay.
Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Man.